Hi, welcome to the channel. If you want to understand data science using examples and visualization, then you've come to the right place. This channel is not about theoretical PowerPoint, nor it is about some low-level coding. This channel is suitable for anyone who wants to understand what is data science and what data science brings to the table. In this video, I'll be focusing on how to use data science techniques to convert data into interesting insights. I'll be going through some top 5 commonly used techniques which you see right on the screen or here. So let's get started. But before that, do not forget to subscribe to the channel and like the video. So let's say you have an Excel file with some data on cars, and you have various information such as the brand name of the car, the fuel type, the aspirations, number of door, and other information such as the engine size, the horsepower, the MPG, and the price. Now, one of the most common analytic techniques which you can use is the histogram. It gives you insight into the columns with numerical values. So let's take price, which is a column with a numerical data. So the histogram from price would look something like this. On the x-axis, you have the price, and on the y-axis, you have number of lines in your data with that price. So the first observation you can make here is that most of the prices are between the range of 5,000 and 10,000. And if I hover over this bar, I can also see the different prices which are occurring in this particular bar. Now, you can also use the histogram to identify very low values or let's say error in the data. So for example, if I hover over here, I see a price of zero. Now that's clearly an error in the data because no car has a price of zero unless it is for scrapping purposes. And on the other hand, you can also identify very high values by looking at the rightmost bar. So you see that the car which has got the maximum price in your Excel is 45,400. Let's go to the second analytic technique called the Pareto Analysis. Now, this technique is named after the Italian economist Wilfredo Pareto, and it is also called as the 80-20 rule. Pareto showed that approximately 80% of the land in Italy was owned by 20% of the population. Now, we can use this 80-20 rule in our data to draw some very interesting insights. On the x-axis, you have the price, and on the y-axis, you have the number of records in percentages below that price point. And this graph is basically a graph between the price and the number of records below a particular point. Now, let me apply the 80-20 rule. If I take 80% over here, and then I go right, and voila, I found my 80-20 rule, which says that 80% of my prices of the car are below almost about 17,000. Now that's pretty powerful insight. And if you say this to somebody also, you'll also sound very, very intelligent. Now let's move on to the third analytic technique called as correlation. It means the mutual relationship between two things. We can analyze mutual relationship between all the numerical columns in our data using something called as a correlation matrix, which you see on the screen. On the x-axis, you have all the numerical fields of your data file, and on the y-axis, you have the similar numerical fields. Now, the color of all these boxes, it indicates the relationship. So for example, when I hover over the boxes, I will see a value between -1 and 1 at the bottom of the screen. So all the correlation values are between -1 and 1, and values which are close to 1 indicate a very strong positive relationship, and values which are close to -1, they indicate a very strong negative correlation. And values which are near 0 means there is no correlation between the two values. So for example, let me hover over the dark red box, which is between, let's say, between this engine size and the number of cylinders, which is quite dark red. And I see the correlation value is 0.84, which is close to 1. It means there is a high correlation between the engine size and the number of cylinders. It means that as the number of cylinders increase, the engine size would also be bigger. On the other hand, if I hover over this light red box between horsepower and CT-MPG, I see a correlation value at the bottom of the screen which indicates minus 0.76, which is close to minus 1. It means that these two numerical values are oppositely correlated. It means higher the horsepower you have, lower will be your miles per gallon. On to the fourth analytic technique called as the outlier analysis. Now, outlier means something very different from others. And one of the simplest way is to analyze outliers using something called as a box plot, which you see on the screen. So you see a box plot of the width of the car, and the box plot has got a box in the middle and it has got three vertical lines. And all the points what you see over here, they correspond to the width of the car. Now, if a point is between the two vertical lines over here, it is not an outlier. And the two vertical lines also give a normal range. So the normal range for the width of the car is between something between 60 and 71. Now, all the points which are outside this vertical line indicate that it's an outlier. And here we see that we have some cars with a width of more than 71, which are on the higher side and they are outliers. We can also have outliers on the lower side. So what you see on the screen now is the box plot for the length of the car. And here you see that you have an outlier on the lower side, and you see that you have a length of 141. Which is a lower value compared to the other values of length which are present in the data set. Now let us go to the fifth analytic technique called clustering. And clustering means making groups of similar things. So in our data set, we have almost about 200 cars and almost about 25 columns. And just by looking at this data, it is very difficult to find out that which car is similar to other cars. So now let us use the technique of clustering to make three groups of similar cars. And you can visualize the result of clustering using something called as a scatter plot, which you see on the screen. Each point of the scatter plot corresponds to a car. And the color of the point indicates the group in which it is placed. So we have three groups over here. We have the red group, we have the green group, and we have the blue group. The axis of the graph shows the columns which are important to make the groups. And here the weight and the price of the car are important factors which are determining the groups. So the red group is cars which has got low price and low weight. So if we hover over these points, we can see that we find cars like Honda, Volkswagen, Subaru. And if we hover over the blue points over here, we find cars like Mercedes-Benz. It's more or less BMW, right? So these are kind of cars with high price and high weight. And the green points are all between the red group and the blue group. So as you can see, that clustering is a very, very powerful technique which is going to group, make groups of data, and is going to help you summarize lots and lots of data into small number of groups. And it is a very powerful analytic technique and which has got many, many applications. So hope you liked the video. Please give a thumbs up and do not forget to subscribe to the channel, and see you in the next video.